Last part of the pure theory of public expenditure, that is the Samuelson's approach. That is, in the year of 1954, Paul Samuelson, he published a paper known as the pure theory of public expenditure. In 1954, he published a book, published a paper known as pure theory of public expenditure. In this paper, he formally explained the concept of what is public goods. That is, formally explained the concept of public goods. According to his opinion, public goods as defined as the collective consumption goods. It is defined as the collective consumption goods. Collective consumption goods represent as, those goods which are jointly consumed. There are two important characters of public goods. One is that non-rival, and second is that non-excluded. Non-excludable. These are the two important characteristics of public goods. What is meant by non-rival? Non-rival means that there is no competition here. All individuals, they get equal share. So there is no need of competition. In the same way, non-excludable means that all are included in the consumption of public goods. All are available here. So there is nobody excluded from the market. These are the two important characteristics of public goods. Thus he explained the concept of, the concept of the public goods as, the collective consumption goods. Then, second, he explained what are the main difference between the private good and public good. The main difference between private good and public good shows that, in that case, private goods are which are mainly determined according to the price mechanism or market mechanism. At the same way, here there is a possibility of preference revelation possible in the case of private good. So, reveal the preferences and then market mechanism is applied in the case of the private goods here. Market mechanism and reveal preferences. But this is not possible in the case of the public goods. So, in order to explain or make the clarification between public goods, that is, Samuelson applied the application of microeconomics principle here. He applied microeconomic principle, but he was against the general equilibrium analysis explained by Leon Walras. So then he made the clarification, shows that there's private goods which reveal the preferences. This is not possible in the case of the public goods. In that case, public goods are provided by the government. Public goods which are provided by the government according to the public goods provided by the government, this provision depends upon the desire of the society. That is, based on the society's desire for the, that is, provision of public goods. Desire of the society for public goods, this is the main component explained by Professor Samuelson to make the clarification about the public goods. So, desire of the society. So, preference revelation possible in the case of private good. This is not possible in the case of the public good. So, according to the government, that is, the provision of public good depend upon the desire of the society for public goods. Thus, he explained most efficient allocation of public goods here. Most efficient allocation of public goods. So, in order to make the most efficiency in the allocation of public goods, the desire of the society, how he explained here. So, the desire of the society, to explain the word public goods, he introduced, there are two important concepts here. First important concept is that Pareto optimality. Pareto optimality. And second is that interpersonal comparison. Interpersonal comparison. What is the relevance here? To show the economic efficiency in the allocation of public goods, or to show the efficiency in the allocation of public goods, he explained two important concepts. One is that Pareto optimality, And second is that interpersonal comparison. What is meant by Pareto optimality? Pareto optimality shows that increase the welfare of one individual without worsening the welfare of other individual. Increase the welfare of one individual without worsening the welfare of the others. That is known as Pareto optimality. That is one better off without worsening the others. That is the simple explanation about the Pareto optimality. Then this is the first important concept explained by Professor Paul Samuelson. At the same time, not only the Pareto optimality, he added a word like ethics. Here they say ethics or ethic definition or the word value judgment in economic efficiency or ethical judgment of economic efficiency. This is possible in the case of interpersonal comparison in social welfare function. That's the word here. That's interpersonal comparison show that to explain ethical judgment of the economic efficiency, that is in social welfare function, he interpret social welfare function as interpersonal comparison. That is the relevance of interpersonal comparison. That is value judgment of or ethical judgment of economic efficiency in social welfare function. He interprets social welfare function as interpersonal comparison. These are the two important concepts introduced by Professor Samuelson. Then he argued that if there is an interpersonal comparison is absent, absence of interpersonal comparison, here there is a in the case of social welfare function or welfare function of individual, this is heterogeneous. Welfare function of individuals become heterogeneous if there is an absence of interpersonal comparison. At the same time, he argued that if there is a Pareto optimality, here there is a Pareto optimality, absence of interpersonal comparison, individual welfare allocation become heterogeneous in character. Normally, in the case of Pareto optimality, it is very difficult because that is in the case of according to the government concern, that is the resources are very limited or they are scarce in character. So one better off without worsening the others. This is not possible if there is a scarce resources. One better off without worsening the others. This is not possible if the resources are, they are limited or scarce in character. So if the government, that is according to their opinion, if the resources are abundant, they are infinite in supply. So we can practice, that is here there is a one better off without worsening the others. This is explained with the help of a figure. That is efficiency in the allocation of public goods. This is Professor Samuelson explained with the help of a figure. Here there is a, that is first in the OX axis, it represents as the quantity of public goods and public goods B, and OY axis the quantity of private goods A. Then there are two indifference curves here. One is that N1 L1 and second is that SS1. These are the two indifference curves. Then here there is a one PP1 represent as the production possibility curve. The importance of this figure is that here there is a OX axis represent the quantity of public good and OY axis represent the quantity of the private good. Then here there is a two consumers here, X and Y. X, that is consumer X and consumer Y, these are belong to the community. That is, they are belong to a society. Individual X and individual Y, they are the consumers existed in our society. Then, the importance of indifference curve shows that this is the utility attained by individual consumer X and individual consumer Y. Both are explained, both are shown in the indifference curve, but private goods utility and public goods utility of these consumers are taken into account in the indifference rule. That is both, that is individual consumer X and Y, and indifference curve shows that consumers demand for private good and the demand for public goods, how much utility or how much satisfaction we attain, this is explained in the indifference curve. And PP1 shows that this is the production possibility curve. It shows that this is the productive resources, how to allocate maximum, then maximum utilization. Here there is an allocative of the productive resources, how to produce maximum goods, maximum private good and maximum public goods, how to produce with the help of productive possibility curve. This is known as the PP1. That is production of private goods plus production of public goods, both are interpreted in PP1. Then because of this, how to attain maximum welfare, that is Pareto optimality condition plus social welfare function, both are interpreted by Professor Samuelson. Because of this, how to maximize social welfare with the help of, that is, indifference curve and production possibilities, this is explained with the help of figure. In this, here there is a OX, that quantity of public good B, and OY axis, quantity of private good A. Then the two consumers X and Y. Then first indifference curve S1. And second indifference curve N1L1. So that is the utility obtained by individual consumer in the community. Utility of private and public goods, both are interpreted here. Then production possibility curve to show that productive resources constraint, show that this is the maximum capacity here to produce private and public goods. So that is the how to determine how much private good, that how much private good produced and how much public goods, that public goods produce, this is the constraint here, what quantity they produce. So they conclude that in the case of, that is, Pareto optimality condition, that is social welfare function maximized at point E. Point E show that okay public goods, it is demanded or supplied here. Okay, then if there is an increase the public good, it automatically increase the, that is, the consumption of individual consumer X and Y. That both are getting equal share. If you increase OK2, here there is a K1 here, this automatically increasing, that is the product provided to the individual consumer X and Y, equal share to all. So in that case, OK quantity of public good, it is provided at, that is, intersecting point is that E, it is of, shows that this is the maximum welfare enjoyed by the society or individual X and individual. Thus, he concludes that this is the efficiency allocation of public goods. Efficiency allocation of public goods, that is defined by the Professor Samuelson's approach in Pure Theory of Public Expenditure or Economic Efficiency in the Allocation of Public Goods. Then, based on this equation, based on this important figure, he finally concludes that there are two important limitations here, two important defects here. One is that to reveal the individual preferences, this is very difficult in the case of welfare function. To reveal the welfare, that's reveal the preferences, is not possible in the case of social welfare function. And second point is that this value judgment had no scientific support or scientific possibility is not possible. That's value judgment had no scientific support or scientific operation. These are the two important defects of Pure Theory of Public Expenditure. That's reveal preferences is not possible in this theory. This is practical difficulty here. And second is that value judgment is not possible in the scientific operation. These are the three important theories explained in the Pure Theory of Public Expenditure. Pure Theory of Public Expenditure introduced by Professor Samuelson to show this, there are two important approaches. That is the beginning part here. There are two approaches here. That is one marginal utility approach and second is that voluntary exchange approach. Finally, we reach the whatever the pure theory of public expenditure. So, pure theory of public expenditure that is equal to marginal utility approach plus voluntary approach plus Samuelson's approach that is equal to the pure theory of public expenditure. ഹലോ ഡിയർ സ്റ്റുഡൻസ്, നിങ്ങൾക്ക് എന്തെങ്കിലും സംശയങ്ങളൊക്കെ ഉണ്ടെങ്കിൽ നിങ്ങൾ ആ കമൻറ്റ് ബോക്സിലിടുക. അതായത് എന്തെങ്കിലും നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ക്ലാരിഫിക്കേഷൻ വേണം, മനസ്സിലാവാത്ത എന്തെങ്കിലും കാര്യങ്ങളുണ്ട്, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ മിസ് മലയാളത്തിൽ പറഞ്ഞു തരേണ്ട എന്തെങ്കിലുമൊക്കെ ഉണ്ടെങ്കിൽ നിങ്ങൾ എന്ത് ചെയ്യണം, നിങ്ങൾ ആ കമൻറ്റ് ബോക്സിൽ കമൻറ്റ് ഇടുക. ഇനി ഇതിൻ്റെ നോട്ട്സ് ഞാൻ ഡിസ്ക്രിപ്ഷൻ ബോക്സിൽ കൊടുത്തിട്ടുണ്ടാവും. നിങ്ങൾ ചാനലിൽ നോക്കിക്കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് കിട്ടുക ഡിസ്ക്രിപ്ഷൻ ബോക്സിൽ. ഞാൻ അതാത് ദിവസങ്ങളെ ക്ലാസ് എടുത്തതിൻ്റെ നോട്ട്സ് കൊടുത്തിട്ടുണ്ടാവും.